Zombie apocalypse.
Okay, so topic for today is the design requirement for shallow footings under one-way and two-way shear. So, we are now going to discuss kung paano natin i-designate yung mga parameters ng component ng ating foundation. So, this time we will try to talk about how do we compose, no? Yung mismong dimensions na bumubuo sa ating foundation. But we are limited only to discuss right now the topic of shallow because this will be different, no, pagdating sa deep footing. So okay, so I think we are now ready for to be neuralized. No? So what you're seeing here is just only a typical sample of a foundation. So most likely a foundation should compose of a dimension like the area, no? Yung area ng ating footing, the thickness, so it will become volumetric in dimension. So pwedeng square, rectangular, circular, or whatever shape that is adequate for the design requirement, no, ng ating footing. And of course, ilalim yung mga may soil pressure, okay? Yung soil mismo na pinapatungan. Okay. Also, reinforcement, no? Vertical bars, so I think this is what you call the column bars, vertical, longitudinal. This is the lateral ties, okay? But actually, out of scope tayo dyan. Ang ating composition dito ay itong mga bakal na to. Yan. Yan ang ating i-design during foundation. Pati yung connection actually ng reinforcement ng column papunta dito sa foundation reinforcement. Okay? Kaya dito, kung mapapansin niyo, may bakal na parang tumagilid, no? Kumontak dun sa ating reinforcement sa foundation. So, may meaning yan. So, usually, it has something to do with bearing. No? Okay. So, we will talk about how do we develop this reinforcement detailing. That's the main purpose of this discussion. But the critical part of designing foundation is the one-way and two-way shear. Because soil is very weak in shear. So, therefore, hindi niya kayang i-hold, no, ng matagal si foundation kung ang weakness niya is shear. So, let's talk about the potential source of failure, which is one-way and two-way shear. So before I discuss this type of shallow footing, you should understand na last discussion in our past video, no, we have discussed how do we calculate the soil bearing as a capacity and soil bearing as a pressure. Ano pinakaiba nun? Pag soil bearing as a pressure, yung soil mismo ang pinag-usapan natin, no? Yung binibigay niyang pressure papunta dun sa foundation, papunta pa lang. Pero pag pinag-usapan natin yung safe, yung soil bearing capacity mismo, is yung mismong kaya ng dalin or kaya ng sumustain dun sa foundation. Now, let's talk about this example. So, ano yung gamit sa foundation, which is our main interest? Let's say you have this pressure. No? In-assume pa lang natin itong rectangular in terms of the application kasi meron lang tayong load in a plane na piya, no? Mag-iba usapan natin pag naglagay tayo ng moment, no? By eccentricity principle, so baka magkaroon tayo ng mga triangular, no? So, delimited muna tayo because that will be another topic kasi may transfer of moment. Now, considering this condition, so what do we expect from this ultimate bearing capacity, or I think you can convert it anyway in terms of a condition where net and gross may be applicable as an allowable using the factor of safety. Don't forget that this foundation should be carried by the soil, meaning there is a relation in acceptance of what should be the term is bearing, meaning you have to consider. Now, when drawn in 3D, syempre, kasi assume na natin muna ito na continuous footing as a scale model. Okay, kunwari, yan, no? Continuous footing. Yan. Okay? So there is a bearing area. So how do we arrive to the dimension? Let's say, paano ako nagsasuggest ng dimension of a square? Bakit ako nagsasuggest ng dimension of a rectangular? Because it is the function of the load in application, that is load P, against the capacity of the solid that it can hold. Ayan yung function ng QU. So therefore, they have correlation to what is the area of the footing. No? So, from time to time, for us to identify kung anong dimension ng footing ang kailangan natin gamitin, we should know first, no, yung condition ng dalawa, no, foundation and the concrete, para magkaroon tayo ng area of the footing. Doon pa lang tayo magsisimula ng design. Kasi nung sa past videos, alam na natin dimensions, so we can calculate. So, ang tanong, what if I don't know the dimensions? So, can I use the dimension that are being discussed before? Yes. Yung nga lang, hindi mo agad muna magagamit. Kasi, mangyari, for, ano na lang siya, no? Inclusion na lang siya doon sa investigatory part. So, ganun ang mangyayari doon. So, parang hindi naman siya iuhuli, but it would be a latter part, no, to understand if that is really the case of the soil bearing. So, pwede mo siyang i-check. Tandaan nyo, whenever you design, you go back to investigation. Pag may nawalan ng parameter at nilagyan mo ng parameter, it is design and then go back to investigation. Well, yung dati, we are just only investigating. Okay, so that's how we do the tier of designing, ano. When you investigate, that's it, no? Say safe or unsafe. Pero pag when you design, don't forget to investigate. Para masabi natin if your dimensions chosen are adequate or not. Okay, now knowing those conditions, so yun pala yung gamit, no? Na soil bearing capacity na ginocommit natin. So, let's just talk about ngayon yung code behind that can be applied. So, let's talk about types of shallow footing muna, no? So, what are those? So, we have strip or wall footing kasi we need to decide what type of footing are we going to install based on necessity and based on the what is present on the site, no? Kung anong function meron sa kanya. So, strip or wall footing, syempre, gagamitin mo lang to pag meron kang wall, okay? To support with. Okay? Ano pa yung iba na pwede natin gamitin? Sa spread footing, ito yung ating conditions, no? Most of the time. So, pag spread footing, parang sinasabi mo na rin, ito yung dinidesign natin most of the time. Now, ang assumption na spread footing is isa lang muna. It can only support one column. Step footing, ano, kasi meron ka ditong bearing pad na tinatawag, ay, no? Kaya tinatawag na step footing kasi there are some gradual changes of the load-bearing pressure. So, to counter that, pangalawang reason pa pala ay yung moment interactivity, yung transfer of moment from the column up to the foundation, which is, ang foundation is considered slab, no? Slab din naman siya na manipis lang in the other technical term. So, therefore, we can opt to use step footing just in case it is the necessity. So, medyo inclined. May angular value yan. So, may code provision out of that. So, okay? So, we need to understand muna yung mga basic niyan before we undergo tapered kasi there is another provision. Kailangan before you install pile, ano, there should be a cap that will hold the piles. Mahirap naman kasi na dumiretso lang siya at para nakapatong lang. So, it should be also designed. Most likely, overturning moment is one of the potential problem. Kaya, dinidesign ng pile cap. Ito, combined footing. Usually, ito yung mga foundation na talagang kahit i-design mo siya ng isolated, meaning pag sinabi natin isolated, isang footing lang sa isang column. Pero sa sobrang magkadikit na ng dalawang footing, dahil sa dalawang column na adjacent, it is ideal na i-continue mo na lang. Parang sa sobrang lapit na ng pagkakadikit, yan, parang ganyan, no? So why not put a continuous pouring of concrete at pag-isay na lang para maging mas tumaas yung resistance niya. Usually problem yan sa mga may moment weakness, no? Kasi pwedeng mag-cause siya ng sudden impact do sa adjacent footing. So baka mag-create pa ng malaking settlement. And also Matt, pag ito naman ang nangyari is baka yung differential settlement na natin ang may major problem and or halos magkakadikit na yung mga foundation, halos lahat na is nagkakaroon na overlapping, then much better to apply MAT. So there is a good about this MAT footing, lalo na sa uneven settlement to, na tatanggal niyan kasi sabay-sabay yung kanyang pagsettle, but with a controlled amount, no? So of course disadvantage lang nito, medyo bumibigat, but it should be designed by a competent structural engineer. Okay, let's go now to the NECP codes, no? So what code should we understand, no? So first of all, we should understand that we are if you are going to design about the use of a an NECP 2015, well, you should understand, no, dapat alam natin yung ultimate stress design kasi it is concrete. So pinapakita ko lang dito condition. So we need to consider this, lalo na pagka nag-assess na tayo na what is the dimension required for our footing other than having the bearing area. So therefore you should know this one, ano. I think most of us already know this since this is redundantly applied in steel design and concrete design, no? So, ganun din gagawin natin. So, tira natin available loads and then we should use, no? Lalo na ito sa 405.3.2, mentioned that the effect of one or more loads that act simultaneously should be investigated. So, it should be a different set of load factoring just in case nagkaroon changes. Pero sa ating kasi dito, dahil concentrated load naman tayo, so, possibly may iwasan natin yan yun sa 405.3.2. Usually sa beam yan na may continuous action. Unless meron talaga tayong strap beam, no? Pag sabi natin strap beam, yung footing tie beam natin, no, that's another term to understand. Para siyang beam na nakakonekta sa dalawang poste at pwedeng nakakonekta sa dalawang paa yung foundation. So meaning meron kang ideology dapat na ina-apply when to apply and when not to apply strap, no? But of course, footing tie beam is required. Okay, so ito yung under sa NECP natin, design criteria. So it is clearly stated here in 413.2.6.1, no, as mentioned here. So shall be proportional to resist factor loss and induced reaction. So it is understand. Kaya in understand natin solid bearing capacity before, ano, we understand the nature of the load. And well, 413.2.6.2 just mentions equilibrium. And 413.2.6.3 more on ano na ito. Deep beam type ang kanyang analogy, satin type. Usually sa mga ano to, malalalim na mat, no, mat footing. And ito medyo 413.2.6.4 when there will be an application on like external moment of any section of a slip footing is related, yung moment na kine-create dun sa ating member. So meron din kasi siyang tine-check, no. It will be a part of my discussion today. Okay, so ano ba siya sabi ng table 413.2.7.1? So kasi if you recall, say I will try to draw here a footing, yan. Siyempre, pagka meron ka tinatawag na load pressure below, dahil sa epekto ng ating load, say P sub U, tawagin natin P sub U, ito yung factored state. Wala pa yung shear dyan, wala pa yung factored moment, so iba pa yon. So let's say, dahil sa tawagin na natin na U sub NU or the net ultimate, i-consider ko na yung net ultimate kasi I'm disregarding, no, I'm now disregarding the effect of the soil above. So what I want to consider is the concrete alone. So as a function of the P sub U. So tandaan niyo that in Q net allowable, no, just a point of review, it is just only an ultimate bearing capacity minus sigma ZD prime. So ano nga ba yung difference na ultimate, no, U ult, no, kung naalala ninyo ito sa ating past discussion, minus sigma ZD prime. Yaan ang net net ultimate pairing capacity na pag dinivide mo sa factor of safety, nagiging net allowable, no, para malinaw. So, ang understanding niya, dahil mag-create siya ng moment, dahil dito, meron yan. Ang understanding na failure is the crack, eh, no? Kasi dito siya magka-crack. So, meron ditong effective value, no, na mag-create ng moment. Yan yung M sub U. So, yan yung sinasabi. Na kapag ito, crack na ito, no, I will try to use green color. Ayan, ang dinidescribe ng location. So, iba-iba location yan. Kapag ang ating supporting member is a column or pedestal, as mentioned here, so we need to understand yung face of column pedestal, so dun mo siya itututok. Okay? So meaning, parang ito, yung nakadrawing sa kanan. Ngayon, kapag ang condition naman natin is column with steel base plate, well, there is a connection of steel column, well, in between as a bearing condition, so halfway. So meaning, parang ang nangyayari, kung ito yung ating yan, kunyari, may base plate ka dyan. Ito yung footing mo. Tapos ito yung column na let na wide flange. Okay, ito yung bearing plate. Yan, bearing plate. Say BP. Okay. So dito, halfway, sabi dyan. Halfway between the face of the column and edge of the steel base plate. Ah, so, mali pa pala yung, ano ko, yung present, yung aking analogy. So, let's say, palakihin ko ng konti ito. Para mas malinaw. Ayan. Kasi, yan, exaggerate, yan. Ito yung base plate. So, this is the column face. This is the base plate face. And then, get the 1/2. So, kailangan mo lang ng dimension. No? Compute na lang yan. So, diyan mo siya kukuha ng crack. So, para ito yung possibly magkakaroon ng failure. So, pagka concrete wall naman, face of the wall, just like what I have done on the right side, and masonry wall, okay, so halfway, parang katulad nung nasa kaliwa. So, parang ganun lang. Okay, so, ito yung itsura niya, yung dinodrawing ko kanina. So, nagkakaroon ng bending galing sa ilalim. Kasi parang nangyayari, nagpa-punch out na, no, yung mismong foundation sa interaction at saka yung soil below, no, due to the load factored. So, yung QNU, again, is a representation of the load that is being factored, no. So, ano ang magiging, ano yan, assuming, let's say, ina-assume ko muna, nasa column or pedestal tayo, okay? Kaya ang ating distance, ito eh, ayan. So, at the face of the column. Ngayon, sa kanyang cross-sectional view, ayan. So, meaning, ang ating contacting point to create moment is this effective area. Yan, yung shaded region. So, potentially, dyan siya magka-crack. Actually, magkabilaan yan. But of course, one side crack yan. Depende sa direction of moment. So ngayon, syempre, due to resultant, in-assume natin, pag nag-load factor tayo is, well, you will get 0 degree, ano, no, nature of load. So therefore, we understand na nasa gitna lang yan. Kaya F over 2. So for you to come up that moment, as mentioned by the code, so MU should be the area as taken, multiplied by the net ultimate bearing pressure. So, it is QNU times, in this nomenclature, B times F, and don't forget the centroid F over 2, based on this, kasi meron kang ano, interaction of resultant. So, you will get your ano ultimate moment design for you to come up kung ano ang befitting reinforcement that will be discussed later para malaman natin kung ano yung magagamit. Okay? So, ganyan lang, no? Then, the rest will follow. Para ma-design natin yung reinforcement, you will do the same thing kung ano yung ginawa sa RCD, check nyo for C is equal to T, strain check, no? And everything, kung mag-yield ba yung reinforcement. But, of course, ang maganda na sa foundation, most likely, ang ating maximum tensile strain dati, lagi dito, no? You will expect, it is always more than 0.005. So, if the strain is more than 0.005, we are aware that phi is 0.9. Why? There's a liit na effective depth din ito. Dahil maliit lang naman kasi ito. So, we expect that, let's say this is the height, h. So, malamang, ang effective depth din ito, nandito lang, ano? Sabihin na natin, Ay, mali. Sa gitna ng bakal, ano? Ayan. So, ayan, effective depth D. Okay? So, therefore, the lower the value of the D means a larger value of the stress for yielding under steel tension. Walang doble dito. Just only singly analysis. So, therefore, higher chances that Fs is more than Fy. So, wala tayong problema. That most likely that the steel bar under tension will yield. Wala namang compression bar dito. Okay, and then we will get most likely this one, no, na mas malaki. Usually pa nga 0.01, 0.02, very large, no. Now let's talk about shallow foundation. Sinasabi lang dito, the minimum base area of a foundation shall be calculated from unfactored state. Meaning, if we want to get the base area, as I mentioned before, using the state of soil bearing capacity, depende kung anong model yung i-accept natin. Consider zagi ba o si basic, depende yan. Ano. So, we need to understand that the load that should be equated, no, yung kinocompute nating P, the understanding is it is under unfactored forces. Malinaw yan. Sa sinasabi niya. At saka kung may kilalaman man ang moment, kasi may kung may eccentricity, well, already derived naman for strength of material, so we'll try to apply na lang. So, don't forget, it should be under unfactored. Kailangan naman natin pina-factor, anong main reason? We need a larger stress, no? So, therefore, we need a larger force and a smaller area. Ganyan naman ang rule of thumb ng USD. Pero pag nag-consider ka na serviceable state, do not factor the loads. Okay, so ito na, papasok na. Ito importante na. I want you to understand 413.3.1.2. So, overall depth of foundation shall be selected such that the effective depth D, may minimum tayo, 150 mm. Ano yan? That is the depth of embedment. I-assume kaya muna natin ang foundation natin. Let's say, I'm drawing this one. Ay kapantay ng natural grade line. Meaning, ito, ang minimum nito is 150. So, therefore, hindi ka pa pwede bumaba sa depth of embedment. So, mangyayari, kung ang lupa natin ay nasa taas, well, ganun pa rin ang conditions. Mas malaki ang chance na this is more than 150 mm. Okay? So, in 413.1.3, medyo di muna natin ito focus because sabi lang dito, in slope step or tapered, other than that, so, the location of the angle shall be such that desired requires such at every section. Yung pagiging non-prismatic niya, babantayan natin kasi may equal reinforcement na i-require yan. Nasa code naman, but we will try to focus that on one of our video tutorials. So, papasok na tayo sa one-way shallow foundation. So, sa one-way shallow foundation, so, yan yung tatawagin natin, no? Na one-way shear ang mangyayari niyan. So, si one-way shear, pwede nating tawaging wide beam shear. Okay? Pag sinabi nating one-way shear, yan na. Tapasok na yung code natin. Also known as let me erase this. Ayan. Also known as wide beam shear. Okay? Wide beam shear. Or minsan pinagbabaliktad. So, ano ba yung pantawag? Wide beam shear or say, beam wide shear. But usually, as I've read some books, whenever they are using beam wide shear, they are putting a, is this a dash? No? Dash beam wide shear. Yan. Binaliktad lang. So, it pertains to only one thing. Okay? Yung one-way shear. So, sinabi naman dito, ano lang naman eh. Section 407, 409, tingnan natin yung code na mag-apply sa kanya. Now, also, don't forget, meron tayong two-way, isolated. Or tawagin na nating two-way shear. Okay? So, pag sinabi nating two-way shear, okay? Pag two-way shear, an other term for that is, they call it diagonal tension. Okay? Diagonal tension. Okay? With or without dash, no? So, diagonal tension. So, para at least aware kayo sa mga other calls niya. So, sinasabi lang ng code na to, under 4.1.3.3, ano yung treatment, no? Lalo na sa may transfer of reinforcement. Okay, usually gagamitin natin ito for bandwidth. Usually, sa gitna kasi ng reinforcement ng ating kabakalan or still condition natin, I'll explain this one of our session, na nilalagyan natin na may mga mas pasinsin, no? Per piraso, ma-assume na natin kung ilang piraso yung kailangan na papuntang column strip na tinatawag. No? If you are aware of that in RCD or reinforced concrete design, syempre kung asan yung column mo, andun yung strip. So therefore, may mga inoobserbahang ano yan, bilang ng reinforcement using this 2 over beta plus 1. So this is very meaningful equation. No? Magagamit natin one of this discussion. Okay, so let's talk about factored shear. So, ando pa rin tayo sa one-way, ano? So, the one-way shear should be understood by this, by 407.4.3. So, ano yung kailangan muna natin dito? Okay. Ang sinasabi lang nito is the section between face of the support and a critical section located at D. Don't forget it, that the D represents effective depth doon sa ating RCD. From the face of support for non-precessed slab, ito muna focusan natin for non-precessed slab. Okay? And some other criteria to look at. Madali na ma-understand yan. Okay? So, therefore, kukuha tayo ng distance D from the face of the support. What is our support? A column. A wall. Okay? A masonry. Okay? A bearing plate. Yung kanina, kung naalala ninyo. Okay, tabi lang natin muna yan para at least meron tayong pan-double checking. So, therefore, we are aware in our RCD, for us to compute the one-way shear, we are aware of this, okay? That the nominal shear is equal to the capacity shear as a concrete plus the capacity shear as steel. However, there is some rare cases that the VS is a required value. Most of the time, we are treating it as a value of zero kapag hindi kailangan ng stirrups. Diba? Dito man, hindi natin kailangan yung tatawag nating hook bar. Parang tatanggalin na yan. So, minsan, ang baka lang, ini-straighten mo lang. Ito yung reason kung bakit may mga reinforcement tayo sa foundation, bilalagyan ng hook na 90 degrees kapag may VS presses. Pero kapag napakaliit naman ang foundation at yung reinforcement natin, hindi man ganun sobrang dami ang kailangan, makikita natin there's no necessity. Kung naalala nyo yung PVC prime times 0.5, ng ating NCP before sa RCD, ay ganun din ang sinasabi, kung no necessity. No? Ganun pa rin. So, most of the time, that VN is equal to VC. Again, kapag nagkaroon ng VS, kailangan lang ng ano hook bar. Pag wala, then eliminate the hook bar. Okay, so sana naalala nyo to. Sa VC, no, ito yung gagamitin natin. Yan. And 422.5.5.1. Bakit hindi mo natin ito mapapakialaman? Kasi ito, kinukonsider niya na yung may actual, di ba, may list condition. No? Sa detailed, no? So, pwede naman gamitin, pero most likely, hindi na ito mag-take effect sa foundation. Kasi una-una, makikita na natin, choosing the least means the lesser value, eh, most likely, dito ka mapupunta. Nag-i-increase ito eh. Okay? But if you'll take a look on this, well, 0.29 is larger than 0.17. So, therefore, walang problema. Okay? So, ito talaga ang ating makakita sa foundation. Okay. So, how does it looks like? Ayan. So, therefore, if this is your column, mark in X, so you have to measure distance D. D ng alin? Ng footing. Kasi may D ito. Yan. Galing sa main bar. Pero, misa, may discussion si one way na i-discuss ko sa inyo, ano, kailan kukuha sa gitna na main bar, kailan kukuha sa pagitan ng dalawang bar. Kasi meron ka pang bakal dito. Okay. Meron bakal ka dyan sa taas ng main bar mo. Kasi, should, sabi nga, di ba, na code, the reinforcement for foundation should be distributed equally sa dimension. So, therefore, kung meron ka main, meron ka ding top bar, also known as ano, shrinkage or temperature bar, no, para sa slab. Sabi ko nga sa inyo, foundation is just like a slab. They are the same because they are so thick at thin, no? So therefore, balik tayo dito. So ano yung tributary area for the shear? Kasi ito potentially ito yung magsaseparate, eh, no, sa ating concrete, no, under the shaded region. So kung sino yung nagsaseparate, siya yung may failure. So therefore, we need to get this area. So how do we supposed to compute that? Ito, ganun ulit, ano? Make U sub NU ka dyan. So kung ito, pangkumpara natin sa capacity, at ano yung actual, no? Ito naman yung actual. So therefore, getting the product of the area shaded region multiplied by the net ultimate. Again, the net ultimate bearing capacity should be taken from or net bearing pressure under ultimate condition should be taken from the load. Load that is being factored na kasi nasa one way or two way shear ka na. So, multiplied by, assuming, let's say, area of the shaded region na lang. Ayan, tawagin natin area of the shaded region. So, multiplied by the area of the shaded region. Ganun lang siya. Okay? So, di depende na ito kung square footing or rectangular or wall. So, tingnan na natin kung ano area of the shaded region. Okay. So, ngayon, punta naman tayo sa factor 2-way shear or also known as diagonal tension. So, ganun din naman ang code. Pero, may pinagkaiba sila na one-way or two-way. Si one-way kasi, prime the term, ano, parang isang haba lang ang pagkakakrack. Pero, pag two-way kasi, pakalat. No? Ganito itit si two-way. Sabi na 408.4.4.1.1, the slab shall be evaluated for two-way shear in the vicinity of the columns, concentrated loads and reaction areas at critical condition. So meaning we need to understand the support system. Also on 408.4.4.1.2, so meron ka lang ano dito, medyo ano na ito, direction of stirrup. So medyo i-neglect muna natin for the meantime. Ang mahalaga dito, we need to understand, there is a term for two-way shear critical section, so we need to check capacity. So, how do we compute capacity? So, there should be a perimeter P sub O. Ayan, tingnan natin ito. As a minimum, no, but need not closer than D over 2. Ayan, malinaw na. So, ibig sabihin, susukat ka ng D over 2 from the perimeter of the support. So, ito yung mga conditions, A and B. So, pwede edges, column, concentrated, blah, blah, blah. Ayan, nakalagay naman dyan. So, lalo na ito, no? Very important yung B. Para at least kung meron, ay, no, sa A pa lang muna tayo mag-concentrate kasi we're talking about foundation. So, ito. Yan. Okay. So, yung sasabi na 422.6.5, ano yung conditions? Ano yung pwede nating source reference of the capacity computation? Ayan, yung tatlong yan. We need to use these three. So, kung ang one-way shear, isang formula lang muna. Pero si two-way shear, tatlo. So, choosing the least. So, ito, kukumpitin na una. Then, kukumpitin ang pangalawa. Ano yung beta? As mentioned here, is the ratio of the longer to the shorter side of the column. Suppose that we have a foundation. And let's say there is a column. Sabihin na natin C1 and C2. It seems that C1 is more than C2. Siyempre, mag-modeling na tayo ng hindi square. So, the beta factor, as mentioned here, as the longer side over the shorter side of the column. Okay? Ngayon, sa third equation naman, mayroon kami ito alpha sub s, depende. Anong location ng column mo? Is it interior? Use 40. Is it for edges? Use 30. And if that is corner, is that 20. So, depende sa location. Ngayon, kung ito ang given natin, it seems that this is interior. Usually, pag property line, hindi ka pwede lumagpas sa foundation. So, depende sa plano. But you have to understand the condition. So, assuming that this is the interior. Kasi usually, ginigit na reinforce ang column niyan. So, I might want to use 40. If the condition is interior columns. Okay? So, ganun lang. You have to check the plan kung nasa nakalocate yan. So, therefore, after computing 3, choose the least. And then, let us compare that in the actual state. Don't forget that capacity should be always more than the actual. Kasi actual composed of maximum. Otherwise, it will be unsafe. Okay, so binalik lang natin code. Ano? Kung naalala ninyo, I highlighted B sub O, I highlighted D over 2. Ito na siya. Yung B sub O, ito yung C1 plus D plus C2 plus D times 2. Kasi apat na side eh. So therefore, B sub O may be interpreted, no, assuming we have a rectangular support, no, na column C1 plus D times 2, kasi dalawang C1 plus D plus C2 plus D times 4. 2, I mean. Ngayon, kapag ka-square ang column mo, D times 4 yan, C plus D times 4. So, in generic sense, pag ka-square. Ngayon, a shaded region, yung nakita nyo nakalinya na ganito, yan, yan yung failure plane. Meaning, andyan yung pwedeng mag-crack. So, siya yung matatanggal, kumbaga. Matatanggalan yan. So, for you to get the actual, ganun din ulit, ano, meron ka dito distributed net ultimate na rectangular. Saan galing yan? Epekto yan ng load natin na factor. Sawagin natin P sub U. Okay? So, therefore, get the actual by computing, no? V sub C as the actual as U and U, no? Multiplied by, sige, let us have a generic area. Area of the footing, no, minus the area of the surrounding medium, na ito yung may epekto ng B sub O para makakuha ka ng crack line. So therefore, minus this rectangular muna, C1 plus D multiplied by C2 plus D. Kung ito is square, it will become C plus D raised to 2, right? Kanya lang siya. Medyo ano siya, no, butas. Kumbaga ito lang kinukuha mong area for a better apprehension of the computation. So, parang ganyan siya. At shadean ko. Yan. Yan ang objective na ko, ng ating calculation. Computin natin ano yung area shaded by the violet region. Assuming yung buo, area of the footing, at yung butas sa gitna, yan yung area na C1 plus D multiplied by C2 plus D. Again, D represents dimension of the depth of footing as an effective, at yung C1, C2, yung dimension ng column. So, if C1 is equal to C2, that is square. Ganun lang po. Then, let's talk about reinforcement limits. Ngayon, kung mapapasin nyo, dahil sa napakaliit na ating foundation, so most likely, yung bakal din natin kukunti. So, baka mas bumaba tayo sa AS minimum. Kung naalala ninyo, sa reinforced concrete design, may AS minimum din sa slab. So, ganun din yung nag-apply dito. So, ganun din. Ngayon, tingnan natin, paano pag nag-minimum? Ayan. So, therefore, we need to get the minimum by computing this. Depende sa grade ng bakal na gagamitin. Okay? Usually, yan ang code natin, no? Gross of area. And then, choose the greater kapag more than or equal sa 420. So, tingnan natin, is it the same sa ating foundation? Kasi ang foundation is just only, ano eh, slab din naman eh, no? Tingnan natin. There's a term, minimum shrinkage and temperature bar. Ito yung nakapatong sa main bar. Okay? So, may isang code pa na sinasabi, yung maximum spacing ng ating main bar. So, 407.7.2.3 refers to the main bar reinforcement. It should be 3H and 450. So, 3H meaning the height of the foundation. Let's say, ito yung footing natin. Putulin ko na nga lang dito. Ayan. Putulin. Kung may bakal ka dito, ayan. So, ito, kung ito yung D, so the total height is H. So, parang ganun sa RCD rin. Okay? So, may tayong code provision na for ano pa, for the shrinkage bar o yung nakapatong sa ating main bar, use 5H or 450. Actually, paulit-ulit na minemention yan. Meron pa nga ano, meron pa dito. So, sabi naman sa temperature reinforcement, yan na tayo pupunta for foundation. So, reinforcement, tingnan natin, ilang beses sinabi, itong dalawang code na ito, tsaka ito, itong table na to. So, therefore, the reinforcement to resist shrinkage, no, blah, 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 as mentioned here, should be in accordance with this code. So, ano ba sinasabi niyan? Yan. So, therefore, under this, Let's talk about the table now. Let's get direct. The minimum ratios of the form shrinkage and temperature reinforcement compared to the area of the gross concrete. Okay, so they are the same code. Kung napapansin nyo kanina, ganun din ang sinasabi niya. Mumultiply mo lang ito ng A sub G. Kasi ito, nakalagay naman, as a function of the gross area of concrete. So, same kanina. So, same procedure. And also, sinabi niya, ayan, 5H and 450, inulit-ulit niya, katulad nito. Ayan. For shrinkage. Kasi ito, for main bar. Ayan, for main bar. Ay, yung napapatunga sa ilalim. Yung mismong pinaka tensile bar na gagamitin. Okay? Okay, just this one. Shrinkage temperature reinforcement, mention ulit as pertaining to section 407.6.4. So, sinabi rin, ganun din. Oh, ayan, paulit-ulit. 5H and 450. Shrinkage and temperature. Okay? So, that's it, ano? So, thank you everyone for viewing. So, please subscribe to my YT channel. And don't forget to hit the like and share button. So, as a tradition, let me say this to you. You have been Neurorize, and I hope that we will see each other in our next video tutorial. Okay? Have a nice day.